Abbey Wood, the design vision for the station was much more than just building a railway. It was building a railway station and a place and creating a dynamic language that creates a sense of arrival for passengers arriving here, somewhere that previously was perhaps somewhere where people would pass through, but now people now understand and it's put Abbey Wood on the map. And that's really, really key. And it needed not just designers, but it needed a lot of input from Crossrail, Network Rail, and local stakeholders like Greenwich and Bexley to support that vision and bring it into fruition. This interior form of this curving roof is very much about scale of a building. We wanted a very pedestrian scale on the outside. And then as you come into the station, we wanted to sort of really be almost cathedral-like as you come in, and we wanted the shapes then to inform that intuitive movement through down onto the platform. In terms of the local elements that inform the station design, we looked of course at local elements, the movement of locals around the site, the specific site character, but at the time Abbey Wood was a changing place, and it still is to a certain extent, so we had to dig deeper. We looked further afield at things like Lesney Abbey Woods, why people want to come here, how the station would relate to those, the ancient woods, that character. Also the fact that William Morris, the arts and crafts designer, used to come through here on his way to Red House in Bexley. And so that sort of combination of the woods and the arts and craft combined with also what was Abbey Wood missing? And that kind of mixture created this station which mixes both station form and warmth with a more civic exterior and arts and crafts in the junction and the handmade steel components in the roof. It was really important when you arrive at Abbey Wood to have a sense of where you are. And we wanted to bring trees into the station, but because of the technical issue of the interface between the station deck and the road, we couldn't do that. So we brought wood into the station, but we also created a lot of key views with glass throughout the station where we could. So one of the unique things here is how we've designed the station for Interchange. We've not just got the concourse up here, we've got an entrance on the northern side which allows passengers to really easily and fluidly get onto Crossrail, but we've also got a central footbridge which has got escalators and stairs and another footbridge at the end, and that all deals and caters for different stopping positions of trains and passenger numbers. There are too many challenges. In fact, one of those was building over a live operational railway, and also the original station had a lot of ramps coming up and over the railway, and we took those away and we looked at the most convenient ways of crossing the railway, convenient ways of getting from the bus to a train station, convenient ways of moving throughout the station, convenient ways of interchange, how to deal with 10,000 passengers in 3 hours efficiently throughout the station just for interchange, and how to sort of program another 10,000 coming into the station from different areas around the area. What we have done is integrated a lot of the independent components like the signage, we've got the timber seating on the platforms, but one key element that we did bring in was the acoustic cladding they have in the tunnels at the stations, in the underground stations. So we've got the GRC, you can probably see the perforated cladding in the ticket hall, and we've brought that through, and even though that's straight rather than fitting into tunnels, it brings that common theme and design language. We've also brought in the same colour and tone palettes. So we've got whites and greys, which will offset all the signage and wayfinding and the passengers themselves. In terms of the material selection for the station, first and foremost, it needs to be robust and timeless because the station's designed to last for more than 100 years. And how do we define timeless? And for us, it was a combination of a complementary palette, but also defining materials that relate to the locality. One of those was larch, this timber roof, and on the roof above that we've got zinc, and that's a hugely sustainable material. It's about 99% recyclable and will last longer than most other roof finishes, and that's key because we've got three constructions over the railway, three parts of the station that connect over the railway, so you don't want people working at height in those areas, so that was the best possible solution for that. And whilst the larch defines the passenger environment inside the station, that dynamic feel and warm feel and sense of arrival outside the station, it's something very different. The very nature of defining and designing a site-specific response at Abbey Wood informed the shape and nature of not just the building, but the spaces around it. So whilst we've created a site-specific response, we were very much interested in what those negative spaces are between the building and the wider context, each side of the station, and creating a very, very specific public realm and placemaking at three points around the station. And whilst above, it's now seen as a manta ray, that's just simply a consequence of responding to the site. One of the challenges in working on a project of this scale is time. When I started, my son was born, and when I finished, he started secondary school. And that's quite similar to the journey the station takes from sketch to developing those sketches and ideas to delivering the technical designs, and then finally having a building that sits in its wider context. Another one of those challenges, and not necessarily the scale, but dealing with the complexities of the station sitting over two local boroughs and working with them in negotiating on ideas and necessities. And this was also a time when the area was in recession and people were leaving the area, and we wanted to bring them back. And that really informed the uniqueness of the station design. One of the most exciting things I've noticed about since the station opened is not just how busy it is, but how happy people are. And I think the quality that the team have brought here has instilled a sense of pride amongst the community. Maybe that pride existed beforehand, but now you really start to notice it. You see them also being inquisitive about the building. You see them looking at the beautiful roof. And I think that's a great thing.